The Chancellor, Jeremy Hunt, has said an exhaustive process is being carried out to identify school buildings deemed unsafe because they contain a lightweight concrete known as wrack. Over 100 schools in England are being forced to close buildings and classrooms because of the potential danger as pupils begin their return to school. Here's our education editor, Bramwyn Jeffries.
For 104 schools in England, it will be a far from usual start to the term, with a number delaying their reopening and others asking some pupils to learn remotely. It's not clear how long some measures, such as temporary classrooms, will need to be used, but it could be for months. The government says it hopes to survey the remaining schools which need to be looked at within a few weeks. As more buildings are checked, the number taken out of use may increase.
MPs are also returning to Parliament after their summer recess. The Labour leader, Sir Keir Starmer, is expected to reshuffle his shadow cabinet later today. The former senior civil servant, Sue Gray, is also due to start her new job as Sir Keir's chief of staff. Ukraine's generals have reported significant progress in their counter-offensive against Russia's invasion. They say their troops have breached the first line of Russian defences in the south near Zaporizhia. Alexander Rodionsky is a special advisor to President Zelensky.
Hopefully now, when we reach the second and the third lines of defence that the Russians have established, those will be easier to essentially overcome. And perhaps, hopefully, this is the spot, this is the place where we can now actually put all the modern NATO technology, the tanks that we've been getting and the training that we've been receiving, put all of that to use, to our advantage.
Some of the 70,000 people at the Burning Man Festival in the US desert state of Nevada have managed to leave the site, which was turned into a mud bath following torrential rain. Social media posts show revelers walking miles through thick mud with plastic bags in their shoes. Our correspondent David Willis is at the festival and spoke to one woman trapped at the site.
This is kind of hard, so it is hard, I'm sad,
it?
Yeah.
When are we going to get out of here?
Oh, that's a really good question. Everyone keeps saying your guess is as good as mine.
BBC analysis suggests that nearly half of all trains in Britain were at least 1 minute late between January and July this year. Huddersfield Station had the highest rate of cancelled trains. Network Rail has acknowledged that the performance has not been good enough for passengers, but says it's working closely with train operating companies to improve. And proposals that would see a network of tunnels built to link some of the Shetland Islands are said to be at an advanced stage. The local council's been looking at the idea as an option to replace ageing ferries.